believe. They're going to show them the one-to-go signal right there to let them know where the race events are going to start. And we will be coming to green next time by. Understand Heat 2 is in staging, ready to go. Heats 3 and 4. Heats 3 and 4. You need to be staged and ready. And here we go, getting set to come to green. Last night's winner at Tri-County Racetrack, Brandon Overton, set to bring up to green here off of turn number 4. Eyes on him. Green flags in the air, and here we go. Drag race to turn 1. Overton and Hickman side by side off into turn 1 off of turn 2. Inches apart. Overton and Hickman still side by side just like they started down into turn 3. Overton in the middle. Hickman's going to grab the lead off turn number 4 and lead him through on lap number 1. Hickman the leader. Overton going to be in second. Third, Craig Bosberg, and fourth, Jordan Rodebaugh. Then it'll be Craig Greer and Phil Helton here as we get ready to complete lap number 2 here in Schaefer's Oil, Southern Nationals Super Late Model Series, heat number 1. Hickman the leader. He and Overton. Overton rides in second. Overton slipped a bit in 2 right there. Let's Hickman get away from him just a little bit as they settle down into turn number 3. We'll be one lap shy of the midpoint right here. 3 down, 5 to go in a Super Late Model qualifying heat number 1. Overton that time a little better through 1 and 2. Closes a gap between himself and race leader Riley Hickman into turn number 3 now. Hickman working off turn 4, and here comes Overton. He's right there on him down into turn number 1. Shows him the nose to the inside as he'll work off 2 down the back straight away, halfway to the house. 4 down, 4 to go here in Super Late Model heat number 1. Overton again looks to the inside of Hickman, but Hickman just a tick better. Maybe that top side may be the preferred line right now. Hickman a better line off 2 that time. Overton holds to second. Vosbergen is third. Rodebaugh in the fourth and final transfer spot at this point with 2 to go. 2 laps remaining in heat number 1. Hickman a little out of shape. Will that give Overton a chance to get a run on him down into turn 3? Not going to do it right there as the white flag set to go in the air. 1 lap to go here in qualifying heat number 1. Overton slips up the racetrack. That may give Hickman the break he needs. He'll bring him down off of turn number 4. Here for the final time down Main Street at 411 Motor Speedway. Ootowah, Tennessee's Riley Hickman, the winner. He won. Brandon Overton to come home second. Craig Vosbergen will finish in third and fourth. Got to go to the 66 of Jordan Rodebaugh. So your top 4 finishers at transfer on. Fourth, the 66 of Jordan Rodebaugh. Second or third, the 8 of Craig Vosbergen. Second, the 116 of Brandon Overton. And the winner of a Super Late Model Heat Race number 1 in that R1 machine right there. Capital Race Car, Vic Hill Race Engine, American Billet Austin Trucking, Competition Racing Equipment, RH Designs, A1 Towing and Recovering, and Tucker's Mobile Home Service. Big round of applause for Ootowah, Tennessee's Riley Hickman. And they'll show him one to go at the line right here. Buckingham and Lloyd. Pair of veterans setting up on the front row of this one. Looking to get them going clean and green here off turn number 4. Eyes on them. Green's going to wave. Here we go in heat number 2. Buckingham and Lloyd down into turn number 1 there. Moses, the teammate of Shannon Buckingham, not able to compete here tonight. Lloyd going to fall back to second as Shannon Buckingham going to lead the opening lap here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 2. Ivan and Lloyd second, Billy Ogle Jr. third, Austin Neely going to be fourth as Farrell Skelton going to spin that machine around down in turns 1 and 2. Caution, flag is out. Set to bring him down here off of turn number 4. Ivan and Lloyd Jr. in tow. Green back at it. Here we go. Buckingham going to lead him off 2 down the back straight away. Lloyd's going to be second. Austin Neely closing up on Billy Ogle Jr. for the third spot. Ogle not able to compete at Tri-County last night after getting the car damaged pretty heavily up at With Raceway on Saturday night. But back with us here at 411 Motor Speedway tonight. And Shannon Buckingham looking high, wide, and handsome here so far in Super Late Model qualifying heat number 2. In that Fleetwood RV, Tennessee RV, Rev Vehicles for Life, sponsored Longhorn number 50. Ivy Denton Lloyd Jr. in second still. Billy Ogle Jr. third. Austin Neely fourth. And we got a car spun up in turn one and two. The 83 of Jason Walker. Calioka, Tennessee's Jason Walker set spun up in turn one and two. Well, it looks like three laps officially scored. Sportsman Cars, you need to be staged behind that super late model fourth heat ready to go as we get ready to come back to green here. And super late model heat two, Shannon Buckingham showing away. Ivan N. Lloyd Jr. is in second. Billy Ogle third, Austin Neely fourth. Then it is Farrell Skelton and Jason Walker. And Buckingham got a pretty fast hot rod ride here so far in this qualifying heat as he'll come down to the halfway. And, we got caution for the 83 of Jason Walker spun again down in turn number one and two. Flag back in the air, and here we go. We in heat back to action in heat number two. Buckingham showing away. Lloyd and Ogle going at it for second and third. Austin Neely is fourth. Farrell Skelton in fifth. This will be four. Caution flag waved once again as Farrell Skelton spins down in the center of three and four. And the sportsman feature needs to be staged. As, we'll try it again here to get heat number two in the books for you. Buckingham works them off two down the back straight away. Lloyd in second, Ogle in third, Neely in fourth. Halfway to the house, four down, four to go, and it is still Shannon Buckingham showing away out in front. Buckingham the leader, Lloyd in second, Ogle third, Neely fourth. Yes, we'll have two laps to go here this time by for race leader Shannon Buckingham. Two to go in super late model qualifying heat number two. White flag in the air, one lap to settle, and it is all Shannon Buckingham out in front. Buckingham working out of back straight away for the final time. Off of turn four, Morristown, Tennessee. Shannon Buckingham, the winner of qualifying heat number two. Ivan Denton Lloyd Jr. going to come home in second. Billy Ogle Jr. will finish in third. And the three in of Austin Neely rolls home in fourth. Austin Neely fourth. Caution lights out, and we should be coming to green. Steve Casebo, who finished third and the series opener at With Raceway. And a young man with a lot of laps here at the 411. Jason Cardwell set to bring him to green. Green waves, and here we go. The Diva Mob into turns one and two. Who's going to come out of there with the top spot? It's going to be Jason Cardwell. Steve Casebo going to be second. Will Rowland is third. Kenny Collins and Corey Hitchcock going at it for fourth and fifth. Cardwell leads them through on lap number one. Casebo rides in second. Rowland is third. And Collins working his way around. Hitchcock are trying to for the fourth spot. They're side by side working off turn four for that fourth and final transfer position. And Kenny Collins going to hang on to the fourth spot for the time being. Two laps into this one. Field working lap number three down the back straight away. Jason Cardwell showing the way out in front. Steve Casebo riding in the second spot. Will Rowlands holds down third. Kenny Collins fourth. They are in the transfer spot. Folks on the outside looking in right now. The 20 are the 23s of Corey Hitchcock and Tim Dameron as a halfway indicator up for this one. Four down, four to go as Casebo trying to get a run on Cardwell. They are side by side for the lead off two. Down the back straight away. Into turn number three, Casebo looking to grab the lead. He'll fire the slider at Cardwell, working off turn number four. Put Casebo to the lead, move Cardwell back to second. Winner of this one rolls off from position number six. Chase Bolt now out in front. Cardwell second, rolling in third. Collins is fourth, as we'll have six complete right here. Two to go in Super Late Model Heat number three. Chase Bolt and Cardwell riding 1-2 as the front four have gotten away from the fifth place running machine of Corey Hitchcock. White flag in the air. One lap to settle it here in this one. They'll go work off the back straight away and off of turn number four. Richmond, Indiana. Steve Chase Bolt will be the winner of Super Late Model Heat number three. Jason Cardwell is going to be second. Jason Cardwell is second. Will Rowland finishes third, and Kenny Collins fourth. Your top four in this one. Oh. Yes, we'll get set to come to green here in this one. He's out of there off of turn number four. And looks like we're going to stay green. Jakey Martin going to have the race lead. Jake Knowles second. Ryan King, it looks like he's going to have third, and he is on Knowles' back bumper as a Newbert and Mayfield race for fourth and fifth. Almost three wide action there, we thought, for just a moment. But Jakey Martin hangs on to the top spot. Jake Knowles in second. Ryan King third. Jeff Newbert now in that fourth and final transfer position. As we've got two laps scored in the fourth and final Super Late Model qualifying heat of the night. Sportsman Features should be staged and ready. It is all Chicky Barton out in front with that four-race-old Longhorn. Ryan King trying to work beneath. Jake Knowles for second, not able to get it done off turn number two down the back straight away. Jeff Newbert holds down that fourth and final transfer spot. Reuben Mayfield rides in fifth. Barton continues to hold the race lead. We're halfway home in this one. Four down. Field working lap number five of eight. Chicky Barton the leader. Jake Knowles is second. Ryan King in third. Jeff Newbert fourth. And Reuben Mayfield fifth. Laps winding down right here. When Chicky Barton brings them through this time, there will be two laps to go. Two laps will be remaining in the fourth and final Super Late Model qualifying heat race of the night. White flag in the air. One lap to settle it right here for Chicky Barton. Jake Knowles closing up on him here a bit here in the waning laps of this one. But I don't believe he's going to be able to muster enough horsepower to get by him as they work off turn number four. It'll be Middlesbrough, Kentucky's Chicky Barton, the winner of Super Late Model Heat number four. The 66 of Jake Knowles will come home in second. Third will be the 1G of Ryan King. And fourth will go to the 86 of Jeff Newbert. So your top four transferring on. And I believe when they let go by this time, they are going to go four wide. It's my understanding. And the field starts to group up in the four wide. Salute to you great race fans here at 411 Motor Speedway. They'll be 22 strong. You pick your favorite out and wave at them. They're going to wave right back at you and wish them Godspeed for the next 35 laps here at the 411 Motor Speedway. Race fans, on your feet. Wave your hands and caps in the air. Turn the cell phone lights on. Get the fireflies going. Wave those four wide rally towels. It's the Schaefer's Oil Southern Nationals presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV. Here at 411 Motor Speedway, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here they are. In the field, going to see the one to go signal this time by, and we're going to be coming to green. An extremely interesting front row. Donald McIntosh, a former winner here at 411 Motor Speedway, an outside pole will start for David Doherty. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, at the 411, it's showtime! They drag race to turn number one. Who's coming out of there with the top spot? Donald McIntosh drifts up to the race lead. David Doherty looks to have second. Here comes Crabtree looking to the outside. Vic Hill in the mix as well. And Donald McIntosh going to lead him through on lap number one. And we've got four cars tangling here on the front straightaway. David Crabtree involved. Vic Hill involved. Steve Casebolt looks to be involved. Riley Hickman involved. Like the cars in about the second and third rows involved in this tangle, multi-car incident. David Doherty looks to have second. Here comes Crabtree looking to the outside. Vic Hill in the mix as well. And Donald McIntosh going to lead him through on lap number one. And we've got four cars tangling here on the front straightaway. And looks like they're going to give the one machine, a Vic Hill, a push. And the fire rebuilt beneath the hood here off of turn number four. Looks like, and don't believe that start's going to go. David Doherty a little quick on the trigger right there, and they'll pull that one back. But Casebolt has returned. Yeah, we'll try it again. Bring him to green off turn four. Here we go. Hopefully we can get this thing clean and green for you. McIntosh going to go to the race lead. Doherty looks to be second. Hill and Barton battling for third and a fourth. Cardwell looks to be fifth here on the opening lap of this one. Riley Hickman coming through, trying to get fifth away from Cardwell. Now down into turn number one. Here's McIntosh showing the way out in front. McIntosh is the race leader. Doherty got to be in second. Chickie Barton in third. Vic Hill now right there with Barton as well, battling with him for that third position. As Cardwell holds down the fifth spot. Jake Knowles in the 66 car. He is up to sixth, battling with the R1 of Riley Hickman right there. Donald McIntosh looking good out in front here in the early going of this one. Four laps of 35 in the books right there. Four down, 35 remain. And McIntosh, tonight's overall top qualifier, looking good here in the early stages of this one with the Australian David Doherty riding in the second spot still. Chickie Barton third, Vic Hill fourth, Jason Cardwell fifth, five laps in now. Knowles is sixth, Hickman seventh, Buckingham eighth, Ryan King up to ninth, and a Will Rowland tenth, Brandon Overton 11th at this point. As McIntosh going to start the process of working slower traffic here with seven in the books. He starts working traffic here on lap number eight. Negotiates the 0F of Farrell Skelton down the back straightaway and into turn number three. And he'll have him cleared now. McIntosh rolling off two down the back straightaway. Has almost three quarters of a straightaway advantage over David Doherty. Vic Hill riding in the third spot. The 66 of Jake Knowles on the move. He is up to fourth. Jake Knowles in the 66 car. He is up to the fourth position, I do believe. Yes, McIntosh works off the back, down the back straightaway and into turn number three right there. Continuing to work slower traffic as we got caution. Caution is out. As we got a tangle down in turn number four. Shiki Barton in the 144 and the 8 of Craig Vosbergen. And we get ready to come to green here. Green's back at it. Here we go off to number 4. McIntosh going to lead him down the back straightaway. And down the front stretch now. McIntosh the leader. Doherty second. Hill third. Knowles fourth. Cardwell fifth. And McIntosh stretching that lead out here in the early going once again as we start to creep toward the halfway marker of this one. McIntosh on the point, Doherty in second, Hill rides in third, Jake Knowles after starting 12th is up to fourth, Jason Cardwell rides in fifth, Hickman is sixth, Buckingham seventh, Overton now starting to flex the muscle, he's made his way up to eighth, Ryan King ninth, and Steve Casebolt after going to the rear of the fields worked his way back up to the 10th spot. As we've got a lucky 13 in the books, field working lap number 14. And on lap 14, it looks like the race leader, McIntosh, going to have to start the process of working traffic once again as he works by the 83 of Jason Walker. Hill trying to challenge Doherty for the runner-up spot, but nothing doing at this point as Knowles hangs on to the fourth position. Cardwell is fifth, Hickman sixth. As Overton trying to get seventh away from the 50 of Buckingham, he's going to have that done off turn number 4 with 15 laps in the books. Brandon Overton's machine starting to go here toward the mid stages of this event now. Your race leader McIntosh with clear track in front of him, trying to become the first two-time Southern National Series winner here at 411 Speedway and the third different series winner so far in 2017. Showing the way out in front, Doherty is second, Hill third, Knowles fourth, Cardwell fifth, and Overton is starting to charge that top side like a boss, folks. He is seventh, trying to get sixth away from Riley Hickman here as they work off turn 2 down the back straightaway. McIntosh halfway home, 18 down, 17 remain. The Schaefer Oil top 10, McIntosh the race leader, Doherty in second, Hill is third. Knowles fourth, Cardwell fifth, Hickman sixth, Overton seventh, Buckingham eighth, Casebolt ninth, and Ryan King completes the top 10. McIntosh with almost a full straightaway advantage over second place running David Doherty. And Doherty continue to get hit pressure from the one of with Raceway winner on Saturday night, Vic Hill, with 15 to go. McIntosh reeling some more lap traffic here. Hill has set his sights on the 58 of Ivan and Lloyd and attempt to put him a lap down off turn number 2, and he'll have that job done. Full straightaway advantage for McIntosh. Doherty and Hill continue to mix it up for second. Jake Knowles all by himself in the fourth position. And that all-steel engine of Jason Cardwell, who has a lot of laps here at 411 Motor Speedway, holding down the fifth spot. Brandon Overton now has made his way to sixth around Riley Hickman with a baker's dozen left. McIntosh continuing to show the way. Doherty almost got into the lap car of Jason Walker there. And it's let Vic Hill close it on him a bit as that pair works off turn up 4 coming at you down the main straightaway. Hill and Doherty side by side for the runner-up slot as they battle off turn number 2. And Hill with the slider grabs the second position away from Doherty on lap 25. But it is all Donald McIntosh at this point out in front, working the high side about the lap. Craig Vosbergen off of turn number 4 right here. There'll be 9 laps remaining, 9 to go for race leader Donald McIntosh. Almost went into the infield there. Hill riding second, Doherty now third. Knowles is fourth as Cardwell working up with the slower car of Jeff Newbert as Overton continues to charge from his sixth position. But McIntosh continues to be the man here at this point. He'll come off turn number four and lead him down and put lap number 28 up on the board, and there'll be a lucky seven to go for Dawsonville, Georgia's Donald McIntosh. As we said earlier, trying to become the third different winner with the Safer Zorro Southern Nationals, presented by Sunoco Race Fuel and Tennessee RV Supercenter so far in 2017. McIntosh, six to go now. Hill in second. Torti third. Jake Knowles challenging him now as they race down the back straightaway for the third position. Dorty in 25, Knowles in 66, side by side off of turn three. Dorty going to hang on to the spot for the time being as we've got less than five to go for race leader Donald McIntosh. Vic Hill continues to ride in second as Dorty and Knowles mix it up for third and fourth. Cardwell and Overton battle for fifth and sixth. McIntosh works into turn number three while the leader, third and fourth, was coming off turn two. Vic Hill about halfway in between them right there. Yes, the leader, McIntosh, down the back straightaway and into turn number three. There will be two laps to go this time when McDonald McIntosh rolls off turn number four. Meanwhile, Doherty and Knowles continue to battle for the third position. Down into turn number one there. Knowles and Dorty continue to mix it up as the white flag is about to be displayed. The race leader, Donald McIntosh, off turn number four. One lap to settle it. McIntosh with it well in hand. Vic Hill's going to be in second. Knowles around Dorty. He's going to get third here on the final lap. It'll be D-Mac Donald McIntosh winning it to 4-1-1 with the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Bonus Series. Vic Hill will come home in second. Jake Knowles looks to come home in third. David Dorty fourth. And Jason Cardwell finishes fifth. Young man, congratulations. Great job out there tonight. Your race car looked like it was on a rail, a rope, whatever you want to call it. You could take that race car anywhere you wanted to go. Great job tonight.
No doubt. We've been behind the eight ball a little bit, but these guys have stayed behind me, and we've worked so hard to get where we're at tonight. This is the first time I've actually won here in an XR1, so that means a lot to me. But I can't thank Eric and Taylor Watson, David Bryant, Larry Garner, everybody that's a part of this race team. So getting back in victory lane is pretty cool.
Noah, it's been an up-and-down season for you. You've run really, really good at times, and at other times it seems like it's been a struggle for you. I know this is a brand-new race car, I think, or it's not a new race car. I know y'all have got a new one. You're staying with Old Reliable for right now. You'd like to add this Southern National Points Championship to your resume. Three races, you're the third different winner, and you get yourself closer to the top.
This is so one race at a time. We're working hard to get the car better, but I'm looking forward to it. We'll see if we can have a good south run down there in Georgia, but this radio is messing up on me. Sorry, guys, but I'm really looking forward to the South Georgia run, so we'll see what we got.
Big round of applause. Donald McIntosh wins tonight at 411 Motor Speedway. And we'll try to get in here and get a few words with tonight's runner-up finisher, Mosheim, Tennessee's Vic Hill. Vic, wild opening lap right there. Tell us a little bit about that, and then after getting through that, let's talk about the race.
Well, I don't know. Like I said, Steve's raced for years, and he did kind of the same thing a few years back at Tazewell. You know, these little racetracks around here are pretty fast, and first lap especially, you kind of use your head a little bit. It definitely tore it up. It's meant the lower, and it tore up a lot of stuff, but we can fix it. And congratulations to Donald for sure. And we're just really fortunate to get seconds. You know, Stevie, everybody's out here helping me, American Race Tires, you know, all my sponsors, my brother here with Orthopedic Institute, John Tweed with Land Air, and Pilot, obviously. But like I said, I just want to thank everybody for coming out. It got kind of late. Thanks for coming out, and we'll be back here, I guess, in about a year or whenever they have another race.
Hey, I got to ask one thing. What is it about you and bent up race cars here? You've got a couple of wins with air cleaners gone, brakes going out. You got a damaged lower A-arm here tonight and able to bring this thing home in second place.
You know, I've really been concentrating on this thing and worked on it pretty hard to to think about it before I raced it this year, and I've got a pretty good package here for all the tracks in this area. And like I said, even with it bent up a little bit, it was pretty fast. Didn't have anything, I don't think, for Donald. Like I said, it was a handful to drive and try to race and not wreck. But like I said, all in all, a good night.
Big round of applause. Vic Hill finishes second here tonight at 411 Motor Speedway. And we'll see if we get a few words real quick with our third place finisher here tonight. Young man out of Rome, Georgia. He started in the 12th position and brings this 66 machine home in the third spot tonight. Jake Knowles, congratulations. You definitely had a fast hot rod there after about the first 8 or 10 laps of this thing.
Yeah, we went, you know, with a hard tire, and after 10 laps, man, it just went on, and we kept coming up through there and picking them off, and I really didn't know where I was running. That first caution come out, and I was fourth, and I was like, oh, okay, we might have a shot at this. But congratulations, Big Dave and Donald and all them, and Vic. And if it had been 36 laps, I would have got me another spot.
And as he's looking here, I believe Vic may have a flat tire there, as we said here in the interview. Do you wish you could have got a caution there in those last 5 or 6 laps?
No, I think we was about, you know, and without that tire, you know, we was third place car tonight, and the way we've been running, we'll definitely take that. That builds confidence on to the next races, and can't thank everybody, Knowles Race Parts, Coosa Heating and Cooling, Shorty Motorsports. He's been with us tonight and really got this thing dialed in.
Real quick, talk about the retro paint scheme. This one, throwback to one of your dad's old cars. Talk about that just a second.
Yeah, it's a pretty cool deal. These colors was fast back in the day when he was running them. And so that's what we kind of thought. We might could pick up some speed just changing colors. So it's been working for us, and it looks good, too.
Big round of applause to tonight's third place finisher out of Rome, Georgia, Jake Knowles.